Yes, children. So tell me, can you see the screen? Children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Okay. So I hope. Yes, good afternoon. So children, see, from morning you all are landed to Uttarakhand. Yes? So I will be telling you from where do we stay right now? Which district? Where are we now?
Uttarakhand.
Okay. Yes, right now we are in Belgaum. Okay. So from Belgaum, can you see the route here? The red color line. Okay. Now we will go directly to Uttarakhand. Yes, we have been landed to Uttarakhand. And in Uttarakhand, all the mathematical values. Okay. So I will be telling you some important points. Okay. Regarding Uttarakhand. Okay, children? Yes. Yeah. So the distance from Belgaum to Uttarakhand. Okay. So from here, how much kilometers do we need to travel from Belagavi to Uttarakhand? Okay. So the kilometers is 1646. Yes. So it is 1646 kilometers you need to travel, that is from Belagavi to Uttarakhand. Okay. Next, the road distance. Now, if you see the road distance, okay, that is the road transport, it is nearly 1935.4 kilometers. Okay, so from the road, if you go, then it is nearly 1935.4 kilometers. Okay, and if you are going, if you are traveling by train, can you see the picture of a train?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes. So,
children, we all are sitting in a train now. Okay, and we are traveling by a train. And how much time does it take? It will take 41 hours 20 minutes. Okay, so from here our journey begins, and we will take nearly 41 hours 20 minutes. Okay, yes. Now we have come to Uttarakhand, and Uttarakhand, the area is having totally 53,483 square kilometers. Okay, it is not only in meters, but it is such a huge one that it has been measured in kilometers. Okay, and in Uttarakhand, according to area wise, if you go, the largest district is Uttarkashi. Can you see here? The largest area. Okay, district wise, it is Uttarkashi. It is 7,951 square kilometers. Okay. Next, the smallest area, okay, according to the district, it is Champawat. And what is the value here? It is 1,781 square kilometers. Okay, children. So the area, the smallest one is Champawat district, and the largest area, the district name is Uttarkashi. Okay, I have read out the numerical values for the largest district and smallest district. Okay, next, children, how many districts are there in Uttarakhand state? Okay, so Uttarakhand, it is mainly divided into two main regions. Okay, Uttarakhand, you can make two main regions, and it is Kumaun and Garhwal. Yes, Kumaun and Garhwal. Okay, Kumaun, in Kumaun, how many total number of districts are there? And in Garhwal, totally how many districts are there? Okay, so in Kumaun, it is totally 6 districts, and in Garhwal, there are totally 7 number of districts present in Kumaun. Okay, in Garhwal it is 7 and in Kumaun it is 6. Till here, is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. So, children, now we will see what is the population of Uttarakhand. Okay, what is the population of Uttarakhand in total of India? Okay, so in India, what is the contribution, how much the Uttarakhand is contributing its population to the total of India? Okay, according to the percent wise, if you see, it is 0.83%. Okay, total population of Uttarakhand will form totally 0.83% according to 2011 census. Okay, so when they did the survey, okay, it was in 2011, the population percentage wise, it was 0.83. Okay, next, numerically, if you see now, according to percentage, it was 0.83. Numerical value, if you see, I'll read, according to the 2011 census of India, Uttarakhand has population of, yes, children, can you all read here? Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, 1 crore. Okay, so it is 1 crore, 8 lakh, okay, 86,292 population. Okay, so this is our numerical value. It is making in the 20th most populous state in India. Okay, so the most populous state for the 20th position is given for Uttarakhand. Okay, next. Yes, children. So can you all see here? Population of Uttarakhand, it has been given by, yes, bar graph. This is known as bar graph. Okay, so total male and female. Okay, and what is the number of population for male and for female? And this is according to our 2011 census. Okay, we call it as census. They do the survey. Okay, and it has been calculated. This is according to 2011 census. Next one. What is rural and urban, children? Rural means what? The village area. Okay. Urban means what? The city areas. Okay.
City area.
Okay. Very good. Okay. So, children, here you can see a big circle which is forming our complete Uttarakhand. Okay. In that, the yellow portion is for rural areas. Okay. That is the village part. It is making totally 69.77% of rural Uttarakhand. Okay, and for urban, this white part, can you all see the triangle part? It is meant for urban. Urban means what? The city part of Uttarakhand. Is it clear, children? So what is the value for rural? 69.77%. For urban, it is 30.23%. Okay. So, children, as we speak different languages, okay, in our own city, we will speak so many different languages. Okay. So, we will look after languages spoken in Uttarakhand. Okay. So, there are totally 6 local languages spoken in Uttarakhand. Okay. So, what is the number here? It is 6. Which all languages do they speak? The first is Hindi, Sanskrit, Garhwali, Kumaoni, Jansari, and Urdu. Okay, so it is totally 6. 6 languages they are spoken in Uttarakhand state. Okay, yes. So, as we all know that forest is very important. Yes, why forest is important, children? What do we find in forest?
So many trees.
Yes. Yes.
Animals.
Very good.
So many trees.
Yes. So it
and
is.
Animals.
Yeah, trees and animals. Okay. So we need to know how much it is dense. Dense means what? How much it has been covered up by trees. Okay, which is called as a thick or dense forest, and where there is no more amount of plantation of trees. Okay. So here the forest area, this complete part is a forest, okay, in which half has been divided as a non-forest area and forest area. So this blue colored one, okay, it is the non-forest. Okay, it means that there is no more plantation, no more animals can be seen in that area. Okay, so out of 100%, it is 53.7%. It is non-forest area. Okay, and the brown colored part, that is a half triangle, it is for moderately dense. Okay, there is no more thick part of vegetation. Okay, there is no more plantation. Next, the green colored, you can see, which is very dense forest, where there is very more plantation and more amount of animals found. Okay, very dense forest it is called. And the percentage is 7.48 of total 100%. Okay, open forest. Okay, there you can find very greenery. Okay, and the forest is very much open part. Scrub, it is 0.6%. So children, here you can see 0.6%, which is forming very less contribution to the forest area. Okay, can you all see here the light blue colored one? It is known as scrub. Okay, which is no more use, and there is no more forest area accumulation. Okay, yes. So next we will come to rivers. Okay, can you all see there water flowing? Yes, yes. So here in river, yes, rivers in Uttarakhand, the total number is 16. How much? How many rivers you can find? Yes, 16. Yes. Okay, so next one, river Ganga. Okay, so river Ganga, it has been flowing there. Let us see what is the length of the river Ganga. Okay, it has been flowing such a long time. Okay, it is continuously being flown. Yes or no, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what is the length, what is the height, what is the what is it, measurement of our river Ganga? It is not only in meters, children, it is flowing to nearly 2,704 kilometers. Okay, which is unimaginable. Yes, and flows through India and Bangladesh. Okay, India.
Yes,
yes, it has been flowing through both India as well as Bangladesh. What is the depth of the river? Depth means what? What is depth, children? Now, as you go to swimming pool, we will ask what is the depth. Yes, how much deep inside it is. So here for the river Ganga, it is average depth of the river is nearly 52 feet. Okay. Yes. And maximum depth is how much? 100 feet. Okay. So how much deep it is, children? From 52 feet to 100 feet. Okay. Yes. So it is very deep, and it has been very, if you see the measurement, it is having a very huge length. That is 2,704 kilometers. Okay. Next, economy. So children, what is the meaning of, what is the meaning of economy? Economy it is related to money. Okay. Yes. So we will name it as GSDP. What is GSDP? Gross state domestic product. Okay, what is the export, what is the import, these all things will come under economy. Okay, here GSDP is nearly 95,201. Okay, I'm reading out the values. And per capita income, okay, per capita income, it is nearly how much? 1,03,000. Okay, children. So other key industries for the contribution of economy, it will include, so the state, that is the Uttarakhand state, it will get economy by which all ways? Tourism, hydropower, and there is prospective development in the IT companies also. Okay, IT is also very playing an important role in the economy. Okay, next, which is the beautiful city in Uttarakhand? Children, whenever we go to some other place, we will like to see the beautiful city. Yes? So here, now we are going to beautiful city in Uttarakhand. Which is a beautiful city?
Dehradun and Mussoorie.
Yes, Dehradun and Mussoorie. Okay, so if you see the picture, then picture wise the location is very beautiful. Okay, and the Himalaya ranges and river Ganga flowing on either side of the city. Okay, so if the city is here, can you all see? From this city, side by only the river Ganga is flowing. It is a very beautiful to see. The view is very beautiful, children. Okay, next, Dehradun and Mussoorie is the beautiful city in Uttarakhand. Okay, side by only the river Ganga is flowing. Yes, so children, see here, this is the top view of the city. Okay, so from the top they have clicked the photo. That is top view of the city. Can you see there how many temples are there? Okay, and it is also a pilgrimage city. Okay, pilgrimage means what? The people go there for worshipping. Okay, and they go to remove all their sins. Okay, so this is the top view of the city, which is looking very beautiful in the night. Okay, when all the lights are been on. Okay, so this is regarding the Uttarakhand top view city. So children, I'll give you some information regarding the state flower of Uttarakhand. Yes, can you read which is the state flower of Uttarakhand? Yes,
Brahma Kamal.
Yes, children. It is Brahma Kamal. Okay, it is in the form of same. Yes, same. Kamal means what? Yeah, Kamal means lotus. Okay, so it is the same as lotus itself. Okay, which is the white in color, that is Brahma Kamal. Okay, and children, the Uttarakhand we also call it as Deva Bhumi. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Why do we call it as Dev Bhumi? Because it is having land of gods. Okay, the land has been covered with lots of temples, so we call it as land of gods. Okay, yes. So the next one, yes, can you all see here the people, they are in different group. Okay, you can see their dresses. It is completely different from our tradition. Okay, so what they do during the festivals, okay, they wear such type of dresses. Okay, and they will perform different dance. That is a culture and tradition. Here you can see, okay, they are using different instruments for their dance. Okay, next, Uttarakhand symbols. Okay children, so in Uttarakhand animal, the symbol that is used for the state animal we call, that is alpine musk deer. It was adopted in the year 2001. Okay, next, which is the state bird? That is Himalayan monal. Okay, even this they adopted in the year 2001. Next, the type is butterfly, the one which flies. Okay, so here you will find different, that is the name common peacock, even though it is having the same name as butterfly, but the picture is the same as butterfly, the name given is common peacock. It was adopted in the year 2016. Okay, next we will see what is the emblem, the symbol of emblem, which was adopted in the year 2000. Okay, yes, so children, here you can see the picture of alpine musk deer. Yes, is it different from us? Yes. So children, see, alpine musk deer, it is what? The state animal in Uttarakhand. Okay, next, children, as I told you, the state bird is Himalayan monal. So this is the picture of Himalayan monal. Okay, see how beautiful it has been colored. Okay, the nature, how beautifully, even though if you paint, it will not come in such a good shade. Yes, but just look at the God's creature. Here, Himalayan monal, it is looking so beautiful and so colorful. Yes? Next, children, as I told you, the butterfly, okay, the state bird, okay, the state insect, that is a butterfly. The name given is common peacock. Okay, don't get confused. It is the name given as common peacock. Okay, the butterfly. Butterfly's name is common peacock. Yes. So, see here, children, as all the states will have different symbols of emblem, we have the emblem of Uttarakhand here. Can you all see this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Children, yeah. Yes, can you tell me the shape of this emblem?
Diamond.
Yes, diamond. Okay. Yes, children. Yeah, very good. Okay. So the vertices here, they are having totally four, okay, which are having the slant lines. So it is a diamond. Okay. So thank you, children.
Bye.
Yes. I hope you all have. Yes. I hope you all have enjoyed the tour.